This is Jim Nalon, liturgical guitarist. I'm going to share my arrangement of Day Is Done, which is the traditional Welsh melody All Through the Night, a lullaby. So we'll have to keep that in mind as we're working on this one. It's really a lullaby. I'll play it through first and then we'll talk about it. Okay, so we have to, this is a lullaby, so you need to play it very, very softly. Not always softly, but you need to just keep that in the back of your mind as you're playing on this one. This is one that I actually prefer to bar the F rather than use my thumb on. And this first two measures or three measures, you have to get that phrase down really well because you're going to play that three times essentially through the piece. So let's look at that first part, starting on the C and then to the barred F. And when I go from the C to the F, I keep my third finger down as a pivot finger, so I don't lift up this third finger. Makes it easier to get that bar chord down. And then to the D7, now I separate my second and fourth fingers out, spread them out so the little finger's going to the third fret of the second string and the second finger's going over to get the second fret on the bass string. Then get my third finger down in time. I don't have to have the third finger down on the A or the second fret of the third string immediately. I have a moment to get that there. And then the seventh, the first finger gets the first fret of the second string, then back to the G. So those two measures, you really want to get those down. Very legato. Now you can do, if you're a thumb, if you prefer your thumb, you can do it that way too. Either one works, but this is the rare song where I actually prefer the bar chord. And then measure three, you just have the F going up the bass arpeggio with your thumb, and G, and then the C with your first finger down to anticipate the C chord, the last measure in that line, C. And then you put your little finger down on the D, and then we got a little turnaround here. So the bass is the fourth string, third fret. And this dissonance here, the open first string, and then the third string, second string, third fret with your little finger, and then run down in sixth, and then back into the C, so you repeat. So that measure, you'll want to practice a little bit, that last measure, measure four. Or you could even do a double pull-off there on beat four. Do that. So back measure five then, same thing. And the same on the F, same on the G. Now this turnaround is a little easier, the C and the last measure of the second line. Little skip. scale running up to the measure nine. B, C, and then fourth finger, and then... Now, the measure nine, we have two measures, 9 and 10, where we're doing something that can get real monotonous if we don't make something out of it. If you're just going... it's not as interesting as playing it with a little freedom there. And I try and stretch out the time on the first beat of each measure. Make something of that. So I'm holding that long, short, and then speeding, and then pause again. And the last note in that measure 10, the G, scratch that out. Don't play that. I got a little carried away there. I did this arrangement 13 years ago. I'm overruling my old self, and that note should not be in there. You want to separate that from the second half of that line. So it goes. You finished a phrase. Don't hit that eighth note. And then start. Now this one, so the D minor chord there, measure 10, 11. That's one of the most interesting, 11 and 12 are the best parts of the arrangement. So you've got three melody lines going there. You've got the three lines going. You've got the melody line. And you've got an inner voice where you've got the bass. And you've got an inner voice, especially in that D minor measure. So in measure 11, you really want to bring all those out. You're playing the two together. That's an interval of a sixth. No, tenth. So, and then you get this middle voice that's moving. Holds in the middle voice. And so you so I would spend a little time working on these two measures, the D minor and follow the fingering carefully, that'll guide you through it. Then a C over G, so your third finger is now on the G chord. You still keep the first finger down that you had on the A minor, and the second finger stays there. Little finger drops to the third fret of the second string, and then lift your second finger here over to the from the fourth string to the third string, and you get the F, and bring your little finger over to the third fret of the fourth string, and then lift off on your first and second, and then a note that's really, really important here is the last note, the B. That, because that's leading you right into the... So on that B, you got to hold that note exactly until the moment that you put down your C chord. Because if you do... if you had that little pause, it's not going to sound as pretty. You lose the legato. It's got to go right, ba-da, just like you're singing, not ba-da. It won't be as effective. But you can make something out of that note. So starting at the D minor, and then we'll go back into the last phrase. F. This G's a little different. It's a G7, so leave your little finger where it is from coming off the F chord on the third fret of the fourth string. And then one of my little churchy endings here. and you can make that, I mean, in time, that would sound like, or it might even, but I stretch that all out and play with the time on that. And you can do it however feels good with you. That's all I have on that one. So look for more arrangements on liturgicalguitarist.com. I pray God blesses you playing, and I wish you peace.